We live in a small private neighborhood, the neighbors are related to us more or less, distant relatives. Everybody here is a complete nut job. They were constantly arguing over decades before me or my brother were even born. Our property line is kinda like a square and it is surrounded by road from two sides. Keep in mind that on one part of the road we let our neighbors use 1 square meter of the land so they could use the road safer and not damage our property. This is crucial information. This road is made of gravel. The neighbors want my parents and only my parents to pay for the entire cost to lay an asphalt road. My dad and my mother are constantly fixing potholes for 90% of the road, so naturally, our neighbors thought that they will to pay for the asphalt road. Classic car, choosing beggars. Fast forward 20 years, the road remains gravelish. Nobody wanted to pay for the asphalt road. One day my neighbors order a massive truck filled with tons of wood. The truck driver runs over our fence. Nobody wanted to pay for the damage. Our fence is made out of multiple bushes, trees and a little bit of metal fence too. These plants were now completely destroyed and a part of metal fence completely bent. We had to replant these plants and place a new metal fence. My father told me this was not the first time this happened but actually third. I couldn't believe it when I heard this. So this is where the revenge begins. My father is a police officer in the department where they mostly handle frauds, drug busts, etc. He knows the law well. He dug up the property line marker and placed plastic barrels filled with rocks on our property. In the next 6 hours, 3 of our neighbors came knocking on the door because they hit our plastic barrels filled with rocks. They were angry and wanted to call the cops. But they never did. Because everybody knew that little part of land was still our property. One neighbor in particular threatened my dad that he will throw a frickin' pickaxe at my father's back. Over the period of 1 year, these neighbors hit the barrels so much with their cars that the barrels are now worthless. My dad was furious and he changed his petty revenge into a pro revenge. He cut some wood to use it as a mold. He bought cement, sand and metal poles. One peaceful afternoon, my father and I cemented that whole part of the land and placed some lovely flowers on top. So when they hit the concrete they can smell our flowers of victory, defeat. As we expected. 5 neighbors in total wrecked their cars on the new fence and nobody came knocking on the door. Thanks for watching. If you want to see another R Pro Revenge, make sure to